Hi everyone, I hope you all are fine because you have started your studies. Welcome to today's online session. Today we are going to start the fourth chapter of your English reader. The name of the chapter is The Last Lesson. But before that, I would like to request you to please like and subscribe this channel to receive more and more exciting news. Plus, do come and sit with a notebook and a pen so that you can jot down the important points of this lecture. So students, let's get started. The name of the chapter is The Last Lesson. And it's written by Alphonse Daudet. The main characters are Franz and M. Hamel. There are two main characters. One is a student and the other is a teacher. Yes, interesting, no? So one is a student, student's name is Franz, and the teacher's name is M. Hamel. M. Hamel is a teacher of French. So, and he is in love with his mother tongue. He is a very patriotic person, and he is teaching French since 40 years in a school, and all the village persons and the other teachers and the students love him. But the student, the other main character, Franz, is not interested in studies. You know, he's a playful student but is sensitive, and he always comes too late to school. One day when he comes to school, he was in anticipation that today I will get punishment because I am late to the school. But he was in shock to hear that his teacher M. Hamel is going to leave the school, who has been teaching since 40 years. So Franz was shocked that why the teacher is going to leave the school, what has happened. Then the news came that their country has been captured by Prussians, and Prussians warned that the teaching of French should be banned. Instead of that, German should be taught. As a result, all the teachers used to teach French were asked to leave the school. So now the day came that M. Hamel was asked to leave the school. Everybody was very, very sad that we never thought that this day came, you will come. The teacher who has been teaching since 40 years will be asked to leave the school so suddenly. And similarly, Franz was also very sad because he felt very sensitive thing, students. He felt very sensitive thing. He felt that when I got a chance, I didn't pay attention, I didn't study French. And today, my mother tongue is going far away from me. There is no one to teach me my mother tongue. In future, I will never have a teacher who will teach me my mother tongue. So, he was feeling that some part of his soul is going away because everyone is in love with their mother tongue. That's for sure. So, Franz was very sad. And similarly, M. Hamel, he was very sad, and the day came that he was about to give his last lecture on French. So he was teaching, and everybody of the village was very sad, of the school was very sad. They were talking that we are going to miss M. Hamel, who has been teaching since 40 years. So in his lecture on his last day, M. Hamel said that a person should always love his mother tongue, because it's the only mother tongue that will save you from being a slave. It is only the mother tongue of a person that will give you the freedom whenever your country or your people are being slaved by anyone else or are being captured by anyone else. So in his last lecture, M. Hamel also taught a little bit French, but he gave very emotional statements while his lecture. So the moral, the story come to an end, students. The moral of this story is that mother tongue or the mother language, like we have a mother tongue as Hindi, so we should not take our language for granted, because no one knows when like the level of Hindi will go here. So we have to be very, very careful. We have to save our language, our mother tongue. We should always respect our mother tongue, and we should always try our best to create different we should be very careful that we are not disrespecting our mother tongue, and we should keep it as an essence in our heart. So this was the story, student, and it was about a student and a teacher, and it was also about respecting your teachers. It was also about respecting your subject. It was also about coming to school every day. It was also about not taking your schools or your teachers for granted. And last and the most important thing, the story taught us to respect our mother language. So I hope you like this story. Here are some set of assignments. Please read the chapter very carefully. It's a bit longer, 4 or 5 pages. Plus, it has many English words, which are older English words, and there are very tough words also. So try to solve the exercises carefully and do discuss this chapter with your parents, your friends and your siblings. So take care, students. Bye.